All right. So I wanted to welcome all of you to our today's online workshop using the Blackboard Content Collection to manage your course content. And we, of course, we'll just start out here with an introduction. My name is Jeff Geronimo, and I am the e-learning design coordinator here at the Faculty Development and Instructional Design Center. So like many of my colleagues, I do a lot of consultations and training workshops on the Blackboard Learning Management System, as well as on online course design, e-learning. A lot of my expertise is primarily in online and teaching and learning. So it's always a pleasure to be able to host these online workshops and particularly present topics related to those fields. But for today, we are going to be looking particularly at a feature in Blackboard called the Content Collection System. So again, if you have any questions or any comments, feel free to put them in the chat box, and I'll be happy to address those as we move along. Definitely do let me know if for some reason you don't hear any audio. I'll probably just need to jump over to my other machine and restart that there. So one of the first things that I want to do is there are some questions up here. And as I move forward into talking about some of the things that we're going to talk about in this session, think about these three questions that I have up here. And let me know if you have any thoughts. And feel free to put this in the chat box for everyone else to see. So things that I have is, you know, how do you currently organize your course content, whether it's an online course, whether you're putting the course content on Blackboard, how do you currently organize your course content? And do you ever find a need to upload several files at once? And what do you do when you have to update files? So for instance, you've uploaded a syllabus in Blackboard, but let's say later on, you know what, I need to go in and update that. What do you do when you need to update those kinds of files in Blackboard? So if you have any thoughts about that, maybe share some practices in what you're currently doing, feel free to put those there in the chat box as I move ahead here. So for today, this is a one-hour workshop, and the content collection system is a very rich feature. So one of the things that I want to remind everyone is we won't be able to cover every single thing about the content collection, but I will try to go through some of the more commonly used features in this system. So one of the first things that we're going to look at is exploring what it is. We're also going to be looking at things like how to create reusable content within the actual system itself, and then also taking a look at how do we organize and manage content within this particular system. And then, of course, looking at how do we use these files, or what do we do with these files, and how do we link them to Blackboard. So that's really what we're going to be focusing on for today. And Donna also mentioned here that she usually copies content from previous semesters to current semesters. So that's great. We're going to also talk a little bit about what that has to do with like the course copying process. So it's great that you mentioned that comment as well. So good. Wonderful. So I'm going to go ahead and the first thing that we are going to look at is really, what is it? It's always good to know exactly what we're dealing with here when we're talking about the content collection. You may have seen this when you were looking at your course. Maybe this term might have popped up, or maybe you have some previous information on it. But what is the content collection? It is essentially a file repository system. So think about things like Dropbox or cloud storage. It's essentially a central file repository, and you can go in and publish course folders, files within different courses in Blackboard. So it's really that one-stop shop. This is where you can go in and put in all of your files, all of your folders for not just one course, but as you can see up here in the graphic, multiple courses. And you can just simply store all of these course files in just one content area. And so it's essentially like the main hub, rather than, which is as common practice, is rather than just putting the content in each of the courses. And you'll notice here, one of my second points is files can be linked in different areas in a course through the content collection. So let's say you have a syllabus or one file that might be in course number one. Well, if I want to use the same syllabus in course number 2, 3, or 4, well, if I have that syllabus file in the content collection, that means that I can pull that same file into all of these courses, and I'm not actually adding the file, it's just the link. So I'm not using up any course space, I'm not having to drain the resources by uploading so many files or more than one file, because it's already stored in one central location. So then as far as uses, let's talk about uses. Why would you use the content collection system? As I mentioned, the first thing is it is a simple way to store your files. Whether you're used to Dropbox, whether you're used to putting files on your own local machine, if you find that a lot of your content that you're working with is course related that you're going to put in Blackboard or is in Blackboard, it's a great way to start thinking about using it a little bit more so that you can have all your files in one location. As we mentioned previously, it is an easier way to manage all of your content for all the courses, because the way that Blackboard is typically set up is, let's say you have 5 courses. That means that if you're going into each course and adding content, adding files, adding PDFs, all those files go into the course's actual storage space for each course. It's exclusive only to that course. So that can be fine for many of us, but what if you want to find a better way to manage those, all of those files from all of those courses in one place? So that's what we mean when we're talking about easier content management. On the administrative side, a lot of faculty and staff are using the content collection system as a way to store space or store files and materials for conducting faculty staff searches. Human resources has also mentioned the use of the content collection system as well for this purpose. It's great because anyone who is involved in the search process or putting those materials on there can simply log in from anywhere to have an internet connection. Anywhere you can access Blackboard, you can access the content collection system, you can upload files, and for security purposes, of course, you can put what are known as permissions. You can designate who can see the content, who cannot see the content. So there are many administrative purposes as well. This is not just a repository system for just course materials. You can use it for things like searches, things like sharing files within departments. So it's a great way to do that, rather than just emailing files back and forth or trying to send files and then making revisions. It's great because you can just do it in one area. In terms of courses, if some of you might know, you can export and archive your courses. So if you are going to, let's say, be teaching a course later on for a different semester, most of us might be using the course copy process, which is that one-click button that goes in and copies your course to a new semester. But another way you can also do that is save an actual hard copy, and you can export or archive your course. And not only can you export and save those course backups on your local machine, you can also save that in your content collection, so it's always there for you to use. You can save it, and it'll always be there. So the only main difference between that and the course copy is the course copy requires you to have access to that master course. But what if you don't have that course? This is great if you're teaching, in different institutions. But it goes back to being able to find one common place to put all of your content. So now let's take a look at what does the content collection system look like in general. When you log into Blackboard, most of us will know that the landing page will put you right at the NIU homepage for Blackboard. So that's where you can see all of your courses. There's also an actual courses link that goes, you can go in and see all the courses in which you are enrolled as an instructor, as well as a student. So one of the things to that you can also do is, in addition to that, you will find the content collection system here just by clicking that particular link. So when I go in there and I click that link, it will bring me up to the actual content collection system, which you see here. This is just a screenshot of my own. And you'll notice that it's laid out in a fairly easy-to-view manner. You'll see that on the left-hand side, you have different areas of the content collection in which you can go. And by default, what you will see on the right-hand pane here is your personal content area. So this is synonymous with the My Content. These two are the same thing. So if you click on My Content, you'll see this page. And My Content is your personal space, your personal storage area here within the content collection system. So this is where I would recommend that you would store anything that you want to put for multiple courses. So let's say you teach four courses and or teach four or five courses. You could essentially go in here, create four or five folders, each corresponding to that particular course, and you can store your materials there. Of course, we'll address how to actually link those to your courses later, but we're just discussing right now where to store those files to begin with. So you can put them in here in your My Content area. The course content is a different area, and that is actually the content area for each respective course. So what happens is, if you actually have a course within, you know, Blackboard, whether it's one, two, three, or four, or five more courses, each of those courses will have a specified directory, an actual space for all those files. And I mentioned that, you know, it's better to put it in one common solid place. So if you put everything in the My Content area, it'll always be there, whereas any content that you actually upload to each course will be saved in each course, which is fine, but again, remember, it's better to have them all in one area. So it's kind of confusing when I say that, but when we do a live demo here in just a few moments, I'll show you exactly what I mean when I say the difference between the course content and the My Content. But again, My Content is your own space. The course content will have a list of all of your courses in folders. The organization content and the institution content are folders that are used by the university. So if you go in and you might have a departmental folder for searches or for other departmental work, you will generally find that in the institution content area. So you can go in there, and if you don't see many folders, you'll probably only see the content that you have specified access to, which was probably granted either by department chairs, supervisors, but you will find any content that you have access to in the institution content area. And again, that's generally where most administrative staff will store their files. They wouldn't necessarily put it in their My Content area, because if they were going to be sharing it with other staff members will not be able to see your own private content, because as we remember, that is your own storage area. And we also have a few other links here, some library content and some bookmarks. I wouldn't worry too much about those. Those are links to, as you use the content collection more, there are some shortcuts such as adding bookmarks to favorite places in this particular area, so you can add those there. But the main gist is being able to see and view what the area looks like. You can tell that, you know, you have this window. You can already, if you've seen the screenshot, you can see the different buttons, different things that you can add, and different folders that you can create. So what we are going to do now is take a little bit of a closer look into, well, what is it that you can do then? So that means, well, when we're looking at putting content in the content collection, we can create reusable content. They are content that you can either delete or you can continue using it over and over. So what that means is when we look at more of a closer look, this is just a screenshot from the previous screen, but you'll notice that in the content area, or in your content collection system, you have two types of content. Generally speaking, you will have just your folders as well as your files. And by files, I mean they can be anything. They can be you know, graphic files. These two here in the sample screenshots are PNGs. Those are pictures of something. So we have those there, and we also have folders which house more content inside each of them. So when we're looking at creating content and things that we can put in the content collection, they're generally going to be files and folders of some nature. So you can start thinking a little bit more about, well, what can you put? That means I can put Microsoft Word documents, PDFs, images, multimedia. Most things are things that you can upload here in that area. And of course, we'll take a closer look into how to actually organize that, which is, of course, a different process. So let me go ahead and start showing some of the things that you can actually do in here. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to do a quick screen share here in just a few moments. So what will happen if you've gone through some of our online workshops before, I'm going to go do a screen share. So this will just take just a second here. And I apologize if your screen disappears, but just give it just a few moments. So you'll notice now as I, in just a few moments, so you should be seeing my desktop. I'm going to go here and just kind of expand this so everyone can see everything here. Now, if you can't see this, do let me know. You might just need to enlarge your screen here for a second. But you'll notice that one of the things that I have done in this area is the content collection that you are currently seeing. So this is just happens to be mine. Obviously, it will look different depending on what it is that you are actually where you're logged in. So what you might be seeing is maybe a little bit different than what's on your content collection. But again, as I mentioned, what you generally will see is your My Content, which is as of we're in here right now, is by default. You're seeing all these different folders that I had put in here myself. If I go into the course content here on the left-hand side, that's going to take me to a list of all the courses in which I have associations and generally as an instructor role. So these are courses in which if I go to each of these courses and add files, add different documents, they're going to be saved here in this course content area. Okay, so one of the things, again, as I mentioned in the previous slides, is when we're starting to think about consolidating files, it's probably better just to create your own course folder here in this area. So when we're looking at creating this course content itself, here's a couple things that you can do. The first thing is you can, of course, create folders. So I can do that simply by clicking on the Create Folder icon, and instantaneously I have a little prompt here, and I can just call this, let's say if I was teaching a course in educational technology, this could be, you know, ETT501. That would be my folder name. And I have some options here, cancel, create, and customize, but I just want to submit that right now. So I'm going to submit it. And it's already there. It's been added. And you'll see too here that when I add folders and content, as we look around, you'll see that if you remember earlier when I mentioned that we have permissions that we can add. And there's various icons here, different icons. If I click on the one that I just created for this ETT501, if I click on that that permissions icon, I can click on it, and it shows me the screen of all the permissions that certain users have. Well, it looks like that I'm the only one that has read, write, remove, and manage privileges, which is right, because this is in my content area. No one else can see this but me. So if I wanted to, I can go in and customize this and share this with other folks. I could go in and select specific users by different place. Maybe I want to select particular roles, or maybe share it with all users in Blackboard. But right now, I'm just creating content that's just my own. So I'm putting this in my content area. And of course, as I mentioned, I'm the only one that has full privileges to do what I wish with that folder, because it is private and no one else has access to it currently. So I'm going to click here in the bottom right hand corner, OK, to go back. So I have that ETT501 folder. And if I want to put files that are inside, I'm going to go do this as a demonstration. I can just go click on the ETT501. I can go to upload. And I can upload files or I can upload package. A quick thing about what the difference between the two is. If you upload files, that means we're uploading individual files from our machine. I can go in and actually add individual files. And it will just be one at a time. But I'm not going to do that. I just kind of wanted to show what I meant by doing that. So I can go there and, you know, pick a file. There are different options that I can do. These are more advanced options, but generally all we're doing here for the most part is just going to the upload area and clicking browse and then submitting that. So let me see if I can go in there and I might actually pick, you know, a couple different things. What if I have, you know, a song? I might have a song that I might put in there, and I'm just going to open that, and there's a song that was added into that system. I'm going to go ahead and submit now. And what will happen then is that song that I put, that little M4A, that's just a different file. I'm just using this as a sample. But now that file got added. And of course, it will take the same permissions as the top level folder. So if you didn't give anybody but yourself access to that ETT501 folder, well, no one else is going to have access to that file inside. So it kind of works just like the regular permissions and that you might see in any file management system. And of course, there's some information about the size. You know, there's information about the name. Now, if I wanted to, let me go ahead and do this as a sample. Let's say I had a syllabus. I'm going to go right now and open up Word really quickly and just demonstrate me adding an actual an actual file. So if I go in and, you know, create a new file, or let's say if I had an existing file, I'm going to go save this real quick. There's no content in here, obviously, but I'm just going to save it to my computer and just call this as a sample syllabus, because we're going to assume that this is something that I want to put in my actual course later on. So I'm going to go back here to my screen, go to the upload area, upload files. Remember, we're still inside our folder, in this ETT501 folder. I'm going to go to browse, and I'm going to go back to my desktop and get that sample syllabus I just created, which there was nothing in there, but just wanted to show that. Click submit, and I now have my Microsoft Word document inside there. You'll notice that just like with your courses, there is that breadcrumb trail, so I always know where I am at any given time. I can click on those individual links, but we're in my private content areas. I can click on that again, go back to that front page, click on my ETT501 folder, and there's that syllabus I just uploaded. Okay, so that's just a sample of what, you know, you can do. The other option that was in the upload area, this is also a very powerful feature, which I tend to use more in multimedia productions. But if you have a collection of files, let's say you have multiple documents, and you would rather just upload all those documents at once, this is beyond the scope of this training, but what you can do is simply package those files as a zip file, a ZIP, a zip file, and you can upload that as a package. And when you do that, if you upload that one zip file, just as we've done with the regular file, and submit it, Blackboard will automatically extract all of those files and place it directly here in the content system, which is really nice. It saves you a couple steps. So let's say I have, again, a couple of documents, and I know how to zip those files together. The zipping process is very different for both Mac and PC users. There's many tutorials out there on how to do that, but if you have a zip file and you upload that as a package, Blackboard will automatically extract that completely and put them here in your content area. So it's a great way. So this sample that I'm showing you right now is, let's say I am creating a course, an ETT501 course. I'm storing my sample syllabus inside here because then I can always update and do things to that syllabus without having to go to each of my courses, which is a very powerful feature. Because let's say I'm teaching ETT501, you know, three different times in three different semesters. Well, if I use the same syllabus and simply overwrite and update it here in this one central location, that means if I added this syllabus in my Blackboard course and all of those courses, they're all going to be updated at the same time. I don't have to go to each course and update and delete and update and delete. I can do it from one area, and that's here. So that's just one of the features that I kind of wanted to discuss here as I mentioned this. So let me go back real quick now. It doesn't look like anyone has any questions so far. I'm just going to go back here. And what I'm going to do is go back into our area and make sure that, let me go. All right. So hold on one moment. I'm just going to undo all of this again. All right. So we're back here into our main page now, and we're going to go ahead and talk a little bit more then about organizing. So I showed you already, we talked about the actual content, But now we want to look at, well, the organization portion itself. So I already showed you, you know, the basics. We looked at creating the different files, adding files, and then creating folders, which were fairly simple enough as it was. But now, let's say after the fact, when we add those files and we add those folders, what can we do with them? And in this slide here, I'm showing a couple different things. Of course, the main one being that you can, as we mentioned, store, share, and publish your content. And there's various options that you can, that you will see after you upload or create a file and or a folder. So here is a screenshot of some of the files that I've added before. And there's this image file that I have down here. And there's a drop-down arrow, and it gives you a long list of menu options. So there's lots of different things that you can do. You know, one of the more common ones being the open. You can open it to see what it looks like. But one of the things that I always like to point out here is that you have your basic functions. You can copy those files or those folders. You can move them. If you want to delete them, there's a recycle bin, and it will delete them for you. And you can recover those, I believe, within 60 days after deleting them within the system. So it's kind of like your files and folders on your own local machine. You can move them, delete them. Now, one of the more powerful features which you will see here in this prompt is if you have a file such as a syllabus, you will see this overwrite file option. That is what you would use, let's say, if you did have a syllabus. And let's say I posted the syllabus in the beginning of August, but then I find that I had to change it. And you know, the syllabus was already added to my course. It was already added to you know, three different courses. Well, but then I added my syllabus in the content collection, and I just need to update it, but I don't want to have to update it in all the courses. Well, I can go and find that syllabus and use that drop-down menu and select overwrite file, and that will update that syllabus in all instances in which it was inputted. So if that syllabus was added to various areas, it will be updated because I did it in one area. So that's where you would find that particular feature. And of course, there's other settings as well. You can look at more of the advanced features, things like the URL, the actual link to the file. Generally, these content, if you try to, all the content that you upload, they do have a link. But it's not generally accessible to the public. What will happen is if you take that link and you try to share it, let's say you were trying to share this image that we have here, and you found the web link for it, and you were going to type that in, unless you are a user at NIU, you would be asked to log in with your Blackboard username and password before you can see the file. But that is an authentication method, and you can do things like that. But generally, these files will only be available within within the university for those who have active accounts with NIU. So, and one of the other things too that I like to point out is this is a relatively new feature. We have a Blackboard Drive software. This is free for all faculty and staff and Blackboard users. What's nice about Blackboard Drive is it works very much like Dropbox. It will install a small program on your computer, and it links directly to your Blackboard account. So you can actually edit your files in Blackboard locally on your machine without having to actually log into Blackboard. You can, you know, drag and drop, move multiple items. So if you do have tons of files to move over, rather than using that interface that I showed you earlier by uploading one file at a time, you can use Blackboard Drive just by as a regular folder. It will show up in this screenshot that I have here. It will show up as a regular folder within your computer. You can open it up, and it will update, and you can work with all of your files that are uploaded in Blackboard. So it's a very powerful feature. And all it requires is that you download the Blackboard Drive, and it will ask you for your NIU username and password, the same credentials that you use to log into Blackboard. So it's just a great way to save you a lot of time if you tend to make heavy use of your content in Blackboard. I have a link here. This is the link to our actual page on our website regarding Blackboard Drive, and I'm also going to push that out here to the chat area that you can go in and download. And that is just, you know, for you to use in case you'd like to go there and see more information, and the download link as well is there as well. Okay. So, you know, given that it's still relatively new, there may be some issues every now and then, but, you know, I do have this currently on my other machine, and it does work really well. One of the things that we do a lot here is projects, and we're uploading multiple files, so sometimes it's better to have this particular program installed so that I can just go in. I don't have to log into Blackboard. I don't have to deal with waiting for the upload process because it's quicker. Because the folder itself is already on my desktop. Okay. And then the other thing that as we move forward here then is we keep talking about files in Blackboard. We already talked about putting content in the content collection. But now how do we actually make it work in Blackboard? So this is generally going to be the question of the day. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to go back and share my screen, and we're going to talk a little bit more about that and how the use case would be. So I'm going to go back again. Just give me just a second. I'm going to go ahead and share my screen here in a little bit. All right. So in just a few moments, you will see, once I get this actually back up here, all right. I apologize here. Just a second. I'm going to go back. All right. So now I'm back here into Blackboard, and I'm going to bring up my screen again. So we are here in the content collection. We haven't done anything yet with the course. What I've done is, let's say I do have a ETT 501, and I'm just going to put in some files. I already put my sample syllabus here. So what I want to do is I'm going to go actually and see where can I go in and add my files. I'm going to go back in, into an actual course. So I'm going to go to my courses area. And there's plenty of different courses here. But let me just go into one of mine. I'm going to go into a guest course here in just a second. Let's say I'm going to go into a content area. I'm just going to go to a random area here, and this is my content area. So now let's pretend that I do want to add a syllabus, my same syllabus that I already put in my content collection. So how do you actually add that from the content collection? It's very simple. The same way that you would add it in the regular file, I'm going to go to Build Content. And in this instance, I'm going to create it as a file. I'm going to add an actual file itself. So I'm going to come into this screen, and I'm just going to give it a name, call it my, we'll call it Spring 2014 Syllabus. Now, most of us will probably click on the Browse My Computer to get that file, but because it's actually on the Content Collection area, I'm going to click the second button, the Browse Content Collection. And in most areas, you will see this in most of your areas. Now, this is the part that tends to scare some users because you might be coming to this content collection system and you're not sure, oh gosh, well, how do I go and find that My Content folder? Where is that syllabus? Remember that it's saved in your My Content area, and where you are right now is actually in the course repository. This is the area in which you stored all the files for this particular course. Remember, as I mentioned before, if you do that, that's fine, but then later on it becomes harder to manage all those files because those files are course specific. So I'm advocating to put all those files in one particular location, which in this case is my content area. So to find that, I'm actually going to go up here. There's a little up arrow, which is going to take me up to upper level folders. I'm going to click on that, and it's going to take me to more courses. I'm going to keep going up, and what I'm going to do here is click on that users folder, and sometimes you might have to search. Sometimes it does take a while. This part can be a little confusing because you kind of have to sift through folders, but I'm going to click on the users folder because it's actually my folder I'm looking for. And if I click on the users, what will happen then is I'll go inside, and I will see my AID. That's my NIU username. And I click on the A130955, and there is my ETT 501 folder that I had created earlier. So I'm going to click on that, And there are my two files that I uploaded, but what I wanted was the sample syllabus. So to select that, I'm just going to click on the radio checkbox here on the left and click on Submit. So now what happens is the file gets added here. And remember, when we're doing this and when we add the file from the content collection system, we're not taking up any space. We're not actually uploading it again into the course files area. What we're doing is we're saving space. We're only linking to just this particular item that was in the content area. So if you compare that to the old way, if you go to Browse My Computer, you're actually adding that to your course files. And I'll show you in a second another way to access all these different areas that I've been talking about. So bear with me. But this is I've added that file, which is my syllabus. And I scroll down, and one of my things I like to do is I like to make sure that certain files open up in a new window, because if you open it in the same window, it tends to look crazy, and you try to use your back button, and users might get confused. I always try to open files in a new window. Generally, 9 times out of 10, I always set it to open in a new window. And I'll leave the default options the way it is, unless you know this is a special case. I want it to be available. And then I'll hit Submit. And what happens then is that syllabus gets added to this course. So it's the same process for adding files, uploading files, but we're just uploading it to a different location. We're uploading it to the content area rather than creating content and using your own. So of course, this takes a special, you'll have to definitely set aside some time to upload all of your content first, but it's easier to organize your content this way. I mentioned a different way to get into the content area, and you'll notice that you can do this if you see on your left-hand navigation menu. Under Course Management, there is a Content Collection link. Now, if I click on that to expand it, I see all of these different links. The first one that usually appears is the Course Content Collection System. This is the content collection, but this is only for the course. And remember, I'm trying to get out of the habit of not putting content here, because it will junk up your course. And you know, again, later on, if you are trying to update content or find content, you're probably going to get lost, because you know you've got so many courses and you have to keep track of all the files for each course. So I didn't put any of the course content in here. Remember, when we added the syllabus was from our user folder. And that link is also available here in this course management area underneath that course folder, which is my A130955 content. So for each of you here in today's session, this would show as your content. So I would click on mine, my second link, and there's that ECT 501 folder again. So this is all content that is exclusive to me. This is my own area, and that's where I'm going to add more course folders. I'll add more content for more folders and always link to that content. So yes, every time I go into a different course, I can still access my content area. I can still always pull those files. There are other folders here, but I wouldn't worry too much about those, because you generally won't be using these other areas. You'll always want to try to at least look for your own content area. Now, let's say you are an administrative staff member and you happen to have a departmental folder. That folder will probably be in the institution content area. So if I click on that, it'll show me all the folders for different parts of the university and they each have their own different folders. So let's say you have a departmental folder. I would probably check with your supervisor or anyone in your department using the Blackboard system, because you probably already have a folder here. And generally, that's where you would put your content if you're sharing it with colleagues. This is not for courses. This is specifically departmental folders. So if you notice, we have a folder here for our faculty development. This is where I put a lot of my content when I'm sharing it with my own colleagues, or when we're trying to create courses that are using the same content. Because one of the things that our center does is we create a lot of Blackboard courses, and it uses a lot of the same content. So of course, we don't want to go into each of our 50 million courses and update the same one file. We'll upload that one file in our FacDev folder and link to it to each of those folders. And any time we ever need to update it, we can simply go in and just overwrite the file, and it will update all instances of that file wherever it might be in Blackboard. So it's a great feature, and at first you may not think it's a time saver, but it really is when you're making more of the use for your folder. And again, you can do this in any other area as well. I could go out of this courses area. I could go to a different course. I could go to my other guest course here, my guest course 01. I could go to the content area. I could go to build content, go to file. And again, I'll call this, you know, my spring 2014 syllabus, and browse content collection, and go all the way back up until I find my user folder. And of course, it may seem again confusing, but Blackboard will always continue to update these over time. And I go in my users folder, and then click again on my actual folder that appears. There's my 501 folder I created, and the same syllabus. So now this syllabus file is actually linked in two courses. So this is my second course, and I click submit. So if you remember, we put the same syllabus now in two courses. So that means it's a powerful feature. If I ever happen to need to update the syllabus, I don't need to go here and delete it or change it in each course. All I have to do is go to my content collection, find out wherever that file might be, and that's in my content area, go to ECT 501, and next to that syllabus file, all I have to do is click on that drop-down arrow and overwrite the file. And I can go ahead and upload my updated file. And what will happen then when I click submit is it will update that file wherever it is on Blackboard. So again, it's a time-saving feature, and I can't stress that enough. It's a great way to make sure that all of your files are updated in one place. Okay. So let me go ahead now and just kind of minimize this a little bit. And let's see if anybody here has any questions. No questions so far? No questions. Let's see. Oh, it looks like we have one here from Isabel. If my content was uploaded to each course, can I go back and move it from there to this content collection, or do I have to re-upload the files to the content collection from scratch? Great question. Here's my recommendation. Yes, you can actually move your courses. Let me go back to my course here. You can, let's say you upload files to each of your courses. And I'll go and use my one for as an example. I'll go into this BB Learn Guest Course 37. What I need to do is go into the course content collection system, which is, again, I'll scroll down here, go to the course management area, and the course repository is listed here by its long name. So this long name happens to be GUI 2012-FACD. I'll just click on that. That's the course specific folder. And if you notice, there's a blended learning document there. And that was, let's pretend that all of your files are here. You can actually move this to the content collection system. And what all I need to do is select those files using the checkbox. I can use the check all box. But what I'm going to do is, just as a sample, I'll check this box, check both of them. And what I'm going to do is click on move. So I'll click move. And it's going to ask me, where do I want to put it right now? It shows me, oh, I have all these files, and where do I want to move it? Well, what I'm going to do is click in the destination area. I'm going to click Browse. And it takes me to my content collection system. But what I need to do is not put it here in the course folder. I want to put it in my user folder, the user folder that we've been talking about this whole time. So what do we have to do? We have to go and search again, click on the up arrow until we find our user folder. It does take a while again, and it can be cumbersome, but I promise you, if one way to circumvent this, by the way, is to get Blackboard Drive. If you install that on your machine, you will probably not have to deal with this this interface as regularly. So if you know that you're going to be using the content collection system quite regularly, get the Blackboard Drive software. Again, it's free, and it will just attach itself to your local drive, and you can do everything that I'm doing now for the most part, and it's great if you're uploading and working with multiple files. So I'm going to go find my user folder and click on my folder corresponding to my Novell ID, my username. And there it is. So there's my ECT 501 folder. I can just click on that and move it there. And there's no confirmation. The only thing you need to do is click submit. What that means is it will be moving the actual files, and I can actually just put it right within that folder. And I actually don't want to do that right now because I'm just going to click that and click Submit. And that'll get added to that folder and hit Submit. Now, one question that may come up from time to time is, well, what happens if we do all of this great stuff? Let's say I go into my content collection system, and let me go to my EC2501 folder. There's my two files, by the way. So it shows that, yes, you can move files from your course area, your course content area, into your personal area. So yes, you can move that. You do not have to re-upload. You may, but that's going to take you a lot of time. So, but if you have all of your content in your course files area, you can certainly move that. So you do exactly what I just did. I did the move process. But the other question that comes in as well, you know, and some folks have asked me, well, Jeff, what happens if, let's say, I have all these files, but I need to move them. I want to create a folder. And let's say I create a folder here, and I'll title this Course 1 Files. What happens if I have all these files and I want to move them to this folder? Well, I can do that, but then the next question would be, well, Jeff, no, wait, I've already added those same files to Blackboard. If I move these files to this folder, wouldn't that break the link? Well, one of the nice things about Blackboard is that even if I move all of these files to this folder, and these files were already added to a course, Blackboard will actually update the link, so the links will not be broken. So you can actually move these around different areas in your personal area without worrying about the links being broken, because the links are special in that you can link them anywhere, and even in this area, I can move them to that folder if I wanted to. I can move all these to that folder, and I won't have to worry about breaking the link in the courses in which these were already added. So if you notice, my ETT501 folder, that syllabus I added was already here, and if you remember, I added it to two courses already. So no, I could actually move this file into this folder, move it around, and reorganize it, and I don't have to worry about going back into each of the courses and updating the file location. It's very seamless. Which is very nice, and most of us may not think about that, but you know, it's something to keep in mind. So that was a very long answer to your question, but yes. So as I mentioned earlier, you definitely can add your existing files, you know, back into your content collection system, so you will not have to worry about that. Will this process of moving the files erase the files from the course itself, or will they be in both places? So yes, I answered that basically as well. As I mentioned, when you do move files around, the links will not be broken, so you do not have to worry about removing them. You know, and again, let's say this syllabus again gets updated. All I have to do is, I could delete it, but if I delete it, it's going to tell me that it was actually used elsewhere. And I think I can demonstrate that. If I click on this, the checkbox, and I try to recycle, it'll say, you know, it's basically the same as deleting. If I click OK, it will tell me, well, you selected items to recycle that are either directly linked or contain items that link to other places. It's giving me this message because this file is in two courses. So, you know, it will warn you. But the other thing that, again, as I mentioned, is if I wanted to update that, click on the down arrow and overwrite that file. So that's how you would do the file management. There is, and like I said, that's one of the nice things about working with the content collection system is that I can delete, I can move files around without having to worry about, you know, relinking them. You know, the only time you'll have a problem is, let's say you do delete a file and you confirm that you're going to delete the file, then yes, the links will be broken in the course. But you know, as you've seen in the previous few moments here, it will give you a confirmation screen that, hey, wait, stop, this file is actually in two courses. So you know, that's just a safety feature. But so yes, as Isabel had asked, if you move them around, will they break the links? They will not break the links, so no worries about that. Let's see. Any other questions? That was a lot of talking, but you know, I wanted to make sure that I covered as much as I could during the session. We have about 10 minutes left, so what I'm going to do is take just a few more moments here and show you some other things that you can do. if you notice, we're in this sample syllabus file. You can view other options. If I go in and click the down arrow, I could go in and select that 360-degree view option from the drop-down menu. If I click that, it's going to give you a lot of information, but it's actually pretty good information. It tells you things like what's the name of the file, it'll tell you some links where it is and who uploaded it. So this might be more useful for those that are using the content collection system on the staff side. And if you want to know who actually uploaded it, it might be helpful to know who did that. You can go into this 360-degree view. If I scroll down, one of the nice things that it will also tell me is it will tell me exactly where I put this in which courses. So if, in case you're wondering later on, now where did I put this file, it will tell you under the links area where in which course is this file being stored right now. So remember, I actually added this file in that guest course 1 and guest course 37. So it's telling me where this syllabus file is currently in, which is why I actually can't delete it without Blackboard asking me twice, do you want to delete it, because it's actually in two courses right now. And it will tell me you know, where it is. So that's a nice little feature. It's a more of an advanced feature, but it's a great way to see where those files are currently. Okay. So that's the 360-degree view option. Again, to do that, all I have to do is select any file, click that drop-down area arrow, and then click on that 360-degree view. Okay, and also one other nice thing to do is, let's say you do have a lot of files here. What if you want to back it up into your own local machine? You can certainly do that. You can actually do it individually, or you could use the checkmark all and then download all the files as a package. So it will zip the file for you in case you want to create a backup of all those files. So there's a lot of flexibility here in terms of what you can do with your different files. Okay. So I've shown you a lot of things here already. You can also, one of the things that I like to do to make things simple for me is, and this is, again, another more advanced feature, is I go into the bookmarks area, because there's a lot of clicking I have to do. One of the things that I do is, for instance, there is a folder, some folders that where I might actually want to bookmark a folder, so I don't always have to go, you know, hunt through and dig and click through so many folders to find it. I can create a bookmark or a bookmark folder to get me to those places. So that's another advanced feature that you can do here. But generally, you just want to make sure that you focus on where it is that you want to go. So as an overview, or as a review rather, remember that the My Content area is your personal space where you can go in and upload all of your files. No one else but you can see them. The Course Content area is the file repository for each of your courses. And again, if you have files here that you want to move to your My Content, again, you can do that here, or you can get Blackboard Drive and install that so that it'll make the copying and moving over process much simpler. If you have a staff folder that you're going to be using for academic administrative purposes, just check to see if there's already a folder for you here in the institution content area. Okay. So let's go back now into our slide here. I'm going to actually just move over here for a second. So I'm going to go back into our slides here, as we are now towards the end. And of course, if you have any other questions, please feel free to let me know. I'm going to see if there's anybody else. Actually, there was also another question. Can I create a folder in a folder? Yes. So you, as you've seen, when we go in and create a folder, when you go inside, you'll have the same option to create another folder. So you can definitely nest folders together. So yes, Donna, that's possible. Once you create a folder inside, you can add files in another folder, and you can click that folder and add more folders. So yes, definitely possible. Let's see, and again, one of the other, we've already discussed this, but I kind of wanted to put this up here as well. Some of the benefits, again, to linking those files to Blackboard, because as I mentioned, you do just have that one common repository for all the courses that you teach. So do try to see if you can, if it makes sense for you to put it in your My Content area in the content collection system, because then it'll just make it easier for you to update all your files in one location. As I mentioned, you can update and overwrite them, and I've demonstrated that as well. A couple quick facts too is, in case you're wondering, In terms of storage, the course specific folder, which is where all of your course materials might be right now in that folder, the course folders only get 2 gigabytes of space, whereas your personal content collection, you actually get 10. And if you need more space, there's a special form online that you can fill out through ITS where you can request more storage later down the road. So that's, again, another benefit to consolidating your files, because your actual My Content area gives you more space than does your course area folder. Okay, so if you're working with a lot of content, a lot of document, a lot of files, it might make better sense just to put them there anyway in the content collection system. And then one of the nice things too is in terms of teaching the same course again, when you do a course copy, so let's say you're teaching a course right now, fall 2013, if you're going to do a course copy into spring 2014, you're going to teach the same course again, the course copy process will be quicker, because they're not copying as many files in the course, because the files are already on the content collection system. What the course will be copying is just the links. And again, the links will not break when you do a course copy. But of course, it's always good to check and make sure that all of your files are still there. But that is another benefit to consolidating your files in one area, is that when you do a course copy, those files will automatically be there because you're using the same links, and the links will not break. Okay. Do we have any last questions regarding the content collection system? It's already 2 minutes to 1 o'clock here, so I want to make sure that if there's anything else that I go in and cover that. So if you have any other questions, please feel free to put that in the chat box. And again, you know, that's really about it for now. I mean, there's a lot of things that you can do, and you'll notice that as you work through the content collection system, and, you know, again, most of us will probably be using it for our courses, but just know that you can also use it as a file sharing medium with other departmental members. Just make sure that you're sharing them with staff who do have access to Blackboard. Let me see here. And then, of course, you know, later on in over the next few days, we will have this archive available. So in case you need to reference that, please do feel free to find that. One of the other things I want to give you before you go is this is the link. I'm going to put this in the chat area right now. There is a link to a PDF file. And this PDF file is actually the quick guide that we've created for the content collection system. So in case you want to review some of the steps that we've been doing, how do we upload files, how do we link to those files, this is a handy-dandy guide. It's a 2-page PDF file. This is actually taken from our Teaching with Blackboard site, but I'm putting it here in this chat area for you to reference. But it's a great resource, so it will cover pretty much everything that I've shown you here today. But as of right now, we are right at 1 o'clock, so I hope this workshop, as intense as it may seem, hopefully was helpful, and hopefully you learned a little bit more about the content collection system and how it can help you in your own teaching. Again, my email is up here. If you have any questions, please feel free to let me know. But I'm going to go ahead here and stop the recording. And I'm going